sides, Adam.
Domenicali, this vote came as a long House session day was winding down, and it was not as close as some predicted it would be.
So I say to my Democratic colleagues, please think about this.
An appeal to conscience as House Democratic leaders split with their governor Wednesday, engineering the defeat of a bill that would have brought casino gambling to New Hampshire.
In spite of the most intensive lobbying pressure ever, in spite of the most intensive arm twisting ever in this legislature, it still goes down. They barely gained any ground compared to last year.
The gaming interests are calling the vote a multi-million dollar gift to the Bay State, where plans for casinos are moving forward.
Only Massachusetts got stronger today.
Senate backers of expanded gaming were left shaking their heads.
63% of the people in this state support it. It is what it is, and we have to move forward.
What happens to the budget process now?
The budget process in the Senate stays the same. We weren't counting on this being in there.
Someone who was counting on that money to help fund an ambitious agenda was the governor, who lobbied hard but came up short.
She was bringing in individual Democrats, mainly freshmen, but all of them, for 10, 15, 20-minute chats. You know, you can't compete with that kind of pressure from the chief executive.
Governor Hassan expressed disappointment after the vote, but indicated this fight may not be over.
Will you sign a budget that does not have gaming in it this year?
I'm going to continue to work with members of both chambers and both political parties to find a way to make progress towards our priorities, and I'm going to continue to fight for those.
Now, the party breakdown on this vote is pretty interesting. 92 Democrats and 107 Republicans voted to kill the bill. 112 Democrats and 52 Republicans at least wanted debate to go on. You can't call those votes necessarily supportive of expanded gaming because of the procedural nature of this vote. But the Democratic caucus was just about split in half, perhaps indicative of the schism there between House leadership and Governor Hassan. Reporting live in Concord, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.